tomorrow into the FB, and that is a huge hit.
Welcome everybody, here's your coverage of the ProDOTA World League. That's right, myself, everyone, bringing you game after game after game after game after game. We are doing another game tonight. In fact, we're going to do two games tonight. There are actually three games happening this evening, but we're not going to do Navi versus Infused. In my utmost wisdom, I am praying that this game, Dara versus Wolves, is going to be the best of the two games. We might find out in a couple moments' time. Let's jump ourselves inside the game, which has already started off. Now jumping into his drafting mode, waiting for all the last players to connect in, and we can see them. So I apologize if I call them Western Wolves. It is just a bad habit because we had a Wolves team in the World of Dota 2 before. They are the Copenhagen Wolves. The Copenhagen Wolves on the Radiant side, led by Captain Miguel Rise, Angel Playmate, as well as Mania. Over on the Dara side, everybody knows their captain. It is Art Style. If you do not know that name, then you need to go back about, well, not too far, actually. He can be invisible anywhere. If you're the first ever exposure to Dota 2 is at the International, you'll remember him as the captain of Na'Vi. He is joined by the man into the stupid freaking tag 333. In fact, I kind of want to just call him that, just because he is using that tag. Maybe. God's in there, Mag's in there as well, and our last one down the bottom is Funic. That is the entire roster out from Dara. Very, very fast, and I love it when this kind of stuff happens. We're going to go through our draft a lot faster. So it's Lashrak, Chen, as well as Enchantress being taken out. So two of the junglers and two of the very early pushers. Chen, a little bit later on pusher, but he's been removed out as well. Lycan and Prophet Brewmother being taken out too, so they're just removing out the Wolves' options for that side lane pusher. And we are going to get to see Darkseer come out for Dara. Of course, all Ukrainian and Russian teams are just enjoying using Darkseer of late. Also got Invoker into their first pick up there from the Wolves. And Brewmaster also going to be taken up too. So that's going to pull him away from the Wolves. Wolves' biggest heroes have been using of late is actually that Brewmaster and combining it with the, I want to say words coming to brain, is the Mirana. The Mirana is what they also use. But they're going to go up with a classic strat, and that's a Shadow Demon Disruption, Invoker Sunstrike, and one more Stunning Damager to do the job. And there's that Mirana for Angel as well. So very, very easy. On the top lane, they want to look for a kill, so they can just throw Shadow Demon up there, Mirana as well, and just Invoker can Sunstrike from anywhere on the map. The cool thing about running it with that kind of strat is it means that, well, when you look at going in Invoker, he can go top lane solo if he wants to. Has to go up in Exalt. That's the downside about doing that. You don't get the instant burst damage. If you run him solo mid, you get the two levels up in Exalt with your Invoke ability. So that gives you a decent chunk of damage. I think it's 175.5 or something like that damage which can come out. And that can be anywhere on the map. It just takes that time to cast it and then for it to hit. And you do see it coming. So they're going to look to try and bring down anybody that can catch out. That's using in conjunction with the catcher. That's the amplifying the damage, is the Shadow Demon ability. So that's what it's all about. Also, guys, if you are wondering about what has changed with the live stream and the quality, we are attempting something new and different tonight. We are going out in 1080p. If you have wondering, going, whoa, we're going to attempt it. It's just for tonight. So please, if you can post up on joinDOTA.com, give us some feedback about what you thought of the quality of the live stream and how it all goes. The way we're getting around it is because I don't know if you guys know, when you try and record something as well as live streaming, you cannot do HD. It's just not possible to do it. So what we're going to do is we're actually recording directly to Own3D TV tonight. So it gets you your VODs faster, and I can also increase the quality of the live stream. But we want to see how it's going to run first. So tonight is a bit of a trial thing. So we'll see how it goes. And please definitely do give us the feedback over at joinDOTA.com. That can also explain to everyone going, what the hell's going on with the live stream? Reason why. How's our last base looking? So Scylla as well as Bane's been taken out. A couple of teams just, they're dabbling with Bane here and there. But it's always for that single focus kind of like lineup you've got. But you've got an Enigma there. You've got a Darkseer and a Brewmaster there. All of that is mainly AoE. That's what it's all about. Jump yourself in there, blast the living crap out of everybody, have a huge ass up for team fight, and now they can also add a Batrider. Careful with that flame break. Do not knock those people out of the black hole. Just saying, it can happen. But Batrider is also going to be selected up here. Really coming back into the scene. Batrider, people are finding a big, big use for him, mainly to win the lanes. It's not being a jungle hero. It's actually just having that great disable And it's not just a disable, like, they've got that stun disable or something like that. This is a, I'm going to lasso you, and then pull you back into a position which I enjoy playing with. And then you have Enigma Malifaux stun to hold him in place, the vacuum to come out from the Darkseer. And then you got Brewmaster bouncing around the place, sending people up in the air. So it's good disables, it's good stuns, and it's good amount of damage you get out of it as well. Not to mention the slow for the chase. You can remember that Napalm stack very early on is great for trying to control those lanes, especially if you've got melee stacked heroes, or heroes that want to have extra movement speed to try and stay on top of those lanes, which Mirana kind of does. You get a couple of napalm stacks on her, leaps away, and then all of a sudden that speed boost which she normally gets from the leap doesn't really have much effect. It's the same with the Windrunner kind of thing, but Windrunner, it's kind of like she's fast on her foot anyway. She'll get away safely. So it looks like they're going to have a bit of a safe lane with that one. So it's going to be ES and Windrunner to be the assumed top lane for the Wolves. And you look over towards the middle lane, it could be the Mirana, but more than likely, it could be. It actually really could be. But Mirana more than likely will head down towards the bottom lane. He'll combine himself with a Shadow Demon, and that will then leave the Invoker to stall up the middle lane. But in saying that, we might even see Windrunner head down bottom lane, and they'll throw the ES up on top. Depending on how aggressive the Wolves want to be, they do like to run when they've got that Mirana, that tri-lane on top, and just try and find anybody out there to gank. That is their big, big thing. The only thing which makes me think they might not do that is because they don't have a jungle hero. Generally, they use the Chen or the Enchantress in the hands of Ryze to do that kind of harassment and die back past the towers. But in this case, it's not going to happen. Over towards Dera, they have had their final pickup too, so it's going to be the Lich. So as far as their lanes go, they can go multiple ways. Enigma can go into the jungle if he wants to, he can go down towards that solo bot. But our other lanes go, Darkseer could also go that solo bot. So there's a lot of options. We've kind of got a jungle here no matter what. It's just, does Brewmaster and Lich go in towards the middle lane, leave Darkseer bot, Batrider up on top lane, which is not going to be the easiest thing if the Wolves decide to go that aggressive tri-lane. Let's jump ourselves really into the game. Realize I also just need to do that little click-click, and we can have ourselves the teams. So we have ourselves a pause. It's no way for anyone in particular. So it's just that pause at the start of a game, which everybody seems to want, so they can gain their bearings. I'm glad I'm seeing someone in there. Who's that in the chat? It's Anonymous8141. The quality of the stream is beyond epic. Thank you, man. I like that description. I really do like that description. I've also been told, too, so for all those people out there who talk about the low-quality streams and what happens with that, there's been a rather large overhaul to a lot of the HD network for Own3D TV, but they're doing all of the low-quality stuff around the middle of next week. You would also notice Own3D TV has had a complete facelift on their main site, and big thanks to them for keeping us as a featured stream up on the top of that. Hopefully this does look amazing quality for you. And the low quality streamers out there, we also had the 480p stream enabled for people out there as well. So hopefully you do enjoy that one. But the low quality stream should be becoming a lot more stable from the middle of next week for everybody out there. All right, so we get to resume the game up. Let's roll, rock, and or rumble. Who are we going to have playing what? So Angel playing as Mirana. Yep, couldn't see that one coming, could we? following him up towards the top lane, it looks to be Ryze. So Ryze will be setting up with him on the top lane. Mania is heading down towards the bottom lane, so it looks to be a pull job for him, and he'll be helping our playmate. And that's going to leave Miguel to solo up the middle lane. So the Invoker's going to be safe on bottom, and they're going to try and get this combo right. Not the easiest thing for Angel to do. A lot of the stuns, a lot of people have been using, like, the Lestrike to Shadow Demon stun, because you know, no matter what happens, that disruption is always 2.5 seconds. The banishment is always 2.5 seconds. So what Angel has to do is make sure he times it right for the flight of his arrow to make sure that hits. How are we looking for Dera? They're going a long way around. I'm guessing they're thinking that Wolves are running up this direction and they'll gank him around here. But the Wolves are nowhere near there. It's actually a smart thing to do by Dera, because the Wolves, the amount of time they've been searching for kills on that top lane very early on, they've even gone a little bit more aggressive and run up into this little area around here looking for those ganks. But Dera is cleaning out their entire jungle. They want to make sure it's safe. And it is so. Looks like Enigma will be going in that solo bottom lane. So Funnick will be taking that Enigma down towards the bottom. Already with 5 clarities. He's got an Observer Ward so he doesn't get ganked. So we'll see that being placed around here a couple of moments later. Just so he can have a nice little vision around this little area. As well as keep tabs on the rune here. But he's got those 5 clarities and then going to go into the Sol Ring. and Liz is going to help him out too. So it's actually, are they going to run a double deny lane on the bottom? This I would like. It's been a while since we've seen this. It's probably been about a month, or maybe even two. I'm trying to remember the last game where the double deny lane happened. But just have Enigma converting off once, and two creeps out of the four get through. This is Lich sacrificing, and then the Enigma as well. The creep wave is completely and utterly demolished, and Miguel gets very little to no XP. But Arsal, he will be going in towards the middle lane. He'll be playing as that Lich. And that's going to leave the Brewmaster there. So they want to have the upper hand in this middle lane. So it's just a double denier. That's the way they're going to look at it. And Mag is actually going to go a jungle Batrider. It's the reason why I see him with that bottle very early on. Allows him to spam off that Firefly a little bit more. Allows him to also tank up too. So I see him double pulling. Considering the creep camp will respawn, he just starts to burn them down. He'll come up, he'll pull this creep wave down. It's actually the easiest, pull. I know a lot of people were talking about NS's blog and the way he just said and the whole pulling kind of thing. And I don't know if you'll see it very, very soon. I'm just checking out if the news has come up yet. We're translating it right now, but there's going to be an interesting news coming up from Rise on the joinDOTA website, being translated from the ProDOTA article. So it shouldn't be too long away. But that'll be about him just talking about the counterpoints of it. Just very, very quickly kind of brought up. But Ryan's kind of liking the way it is. It's just so easy to pull. So you just pull up this direction and get that creep wave to follow you down this way. And then you just pull the other camp off to the side. Makes life so damn simple and gives you so much fast farm. You got a double pull there and he's about to go for a triple. And this is just a nice little stack. The Dive got nice little spots to stack. But then again, the Radiant can also do some nice little fun stuff too. Mania's getting the timing a little bit wrong there. The Alpha Wolves died off before he got the Centaurs to come through that little bit of a path. Look to see set up in the middle lane. It's just Ryze with smoke on. There's not a lot he can really do about this unless Playmate is ready for this, but he's not. We've already seen Playmate go a different build. He's gone Quas so he can stand on the line for this. And that's the reason why we're also, because Ryze hasn't got any levels. This lane only really works, that combo with the Invoke, or the Exord Invoker. It only really works when you have yourself levels up on that Shadow Demon, which means he needs to run a dual lane. That's what he must do. He's not doing it this time around. God able to pick up that regen rune. It's that wonderful ward down that bottom corner there. As I said, just scouting out, so Funnik knows if he's going to get ganked or not. How's Angel going on the top lane? He's the only that big ace up the sleeve for the Copenhagen Wolves. 13 for 3. The most farmed, 14. Now about to be 15 if he gets the timing right. Nope, missed it. But that's all about the farm for him. The gold advantage will still be their way. It would be a lot more if this wasn't happening. But just the fact they're doing that, maybe even Darkseer might be in a little bit of trouble. Angel, he's looking for the line to go and Ryze. Might even start up with a disruption. He's got no real levels on Angel. There goes the arrow, and that's the timing I was talking about. Not the easiest thing to do, especially that close range. He's got to get that time right. Look how much damage Ryze just takes from the, just a remainder of a level 2 shell. It's that iron shell from Darkseer. Wait till it gets up to level 3. Angel's just lucky he's a range hero.
Snatched from the jaws of...
How's that bottom lane going? Funny's going to run in for the 4-minute rune. Nice little way to run it too. Just going to scout out and see what's happening up with Mania. Might even just be able to snipe this Centaur. But no, Mania going to drop the Fissure just in case. Able to deal with that damage. They're also getting some free XP and money. Funnik not wanting to pull them back from the Earthshaker. He wanted them to keep right-clicking so they'll convert out again. How's Miguel looking on the bottom lane? He should be getting a lot of farm. 20 for 3. Yeah, he is. But that Brewmaster's doing pretty good in the middle lane. Right in those bottles, about to pick up the 4-minute one. Or Ryze, he gets in there and swipes the illusion. And Brewmaster emptied his bottle for that one. Disruption's heading up for Arsal, and Playmate's going to come in, trying to go for the Cold Snap. It might be enough damage to bring him down, but then again, Ryze on low as well. Ryze, first blood spilled on him. And Arsal gets out to safety. Now maybe Playmate's in a little bit of trouble. Gold spilled it? No, he doesn't have a crush. He's got nothing else. Just short of his mana by 10 before he can pop off at a second stomp. He might go back in again. Now he's only short by 5, and Playmate, even with Quas, it's going to be difficult to bring him down. But Lich able to escape out, and Daru get the first blood in the middle lane. Oh, we got Soul Ring as well as Bottle flying out. That's for Mag. He needs to send it back and get his life back again. And again with another stack. It's a lot of experience for him. And he'll start to flame it up now. But the napalm stacks for the prep. Just watch how fast this camp goes. I kind of want, like, I know the lanes are going to be important to watch. And maybe even this middle lane if... Nah, it's not. Three stacks and burn it up. And then he smokes so he can keep on the stacking up. Level three. Level four. He had 300 at the start of this one. And he keeps ticking it. And yeah, there's that cash flow coming in. And almost about to pop level five. Big amount of burst. Darkseid does something similar with the smoke. That way you don't take the aggro, but you still have the effect of your ability. Because he only got revealed out. I know there was even a joke clip that was posted up on... actually, I saw it on Reddit. It was over on Reddit. And it was this clip where Shadow Shaman managed to get this beautiful ward trap off, and then the support rolled through the hills and just pushed every other hero back on the other team. And the guy caught in the ward trap goes, well, I got smoke, I may as well pop it. And he sat there on the smoke. He's just like, oh, hang on, these wards can't see me now because there's no hero revealed by. So many abilities, they just cannot touch me because smoke is just so, I won't say OP, but it is a powerful, powerful ability. We got the pings going around the map. We're just gonna pause here, so. Oh, so it's just art style. Having a couple of issues. Having some issues the other night. Maybe it's just maybe the connection coming out of Russia. There's no PGG. At the end of the match last night against Mousesports, he was bitterly complaining about that spider in the mid team fight. It's like, man, I so had that shizzle. So had that. Then the stuns, then the lag. Screenshot Dota. Not the best way to play. It's better than FPS. Just a reminder too, guys, please post up your feedback over on the joinDOTA forums. I don't know if anybody has made a thread about that yet. I'm just checking it out to see if anybody has. No, they have not. But yeah, if you want to post up some feedback about the live stream and the new settings we're using this evening, please do so. Please do so. I am very interested to know what you think about the live stream. To see if it works out nicely at this quality. It should be okay. We did all the testing before anyway, so the stream should be absolutely fine in majority of areas, but as always, the low quality streamers, the low quality settings for the stream will always just buffer a little bit more than normal in different regions. So it's a bit of a problem, but it will be solved later on next week. So it's mainly just the HD we're looking for the feedback from. As our style is having some real problems. So hopefully he manages to sort them out pretty soon. And then we'll be good and ready to rock and rumble. I want to also give a bit of a reminder out there to people as well. If you are using the JD forums, we implemented a new system recently. It's all about reputation. So if you like someone's post, it's kind of like the way you look at it as Reddit. If you upvote someone, they get credit or cred, street cred, something like that. It's very, very similar when it comes to things on the forums for joinDOTA. So if you want to post up in there and you really like what somebody always does, or it's a really good post or something like that, it's really actually helped you out or something like that, please use the reputation button, vote them up, but don't abuse it because we want to see how the community does use it and if it is used properly. So it's kind of like a test period for it all. And if you've got any interest, like if you're wondering about it, you can go to the straight forum area. There was an announcement about it, but there's also some threads about it too. So yeah, just check that out, and yeah, that's what it's all about, guys. Make it real. Erza, is it Erza? Erza. Okay, I can go with that. Enigma's eyes is fine, man. You can just chill. I think it's only when we're paused. But yeah, vote up your community members, man. It's all about making the JD community nice and friendly. So Ryze managed to swipe out the next rune. So that's the 4 and the 6 minute rune both go on the way of the wolves. And it's Ryze both times denying it up. And he's so low on levels, so he's only level 2. And yes, I don't have all these other heroes for Dera. Just gonna get so far forward. And that big spike. Oh, hello, disruption. Middle lane, Fissure as well. Gonna lock God in. Playmate gets up towards the high ground so he can body block this on top of the cold snap. So a nice kill on the Brewmaster in the middle lane. And Arstyle will do whatever harassment he can, but with the three, well, actually, he's only got two on course right now. But still, heightened regen, heightened strength, and just enjoying that right-click power. Giving the vision up on the high ground too. They want to keep tabs on where Art Style's moving. If he moves close, if he moves back, if there is even half an opening. Well, Earthshaker just having a bit of a wander around the bottom rune. Maybe you missed your teammate taking that DD. We're looking on top lane. Playmate. They still haven't managed to shut him down. This can be a big problem for Dara. More than likely, the pain is going to come at the hands of the Batrider. I need that opening to be there. In the meantime, God kill them all. They're going to get ganked up again. He just came back towards that mid lane. Ryze, however, is also going to take a fall, so Artstar gets to get that experience out. Nice little burst with a 3 on that Frost. Oh, wow. Really, Batrider? Arrow? Really? No. No. Mag saw it coming. Now, one little bit of vision. Playmate, however, going to get the Cold Snap off. Let's try and slow him down a little bit. I don't know if Angel... No, he's still a little bit short on the leap cooldown. And can't really throw down another arrow. If he had a leap, he would have got that kill. A leap into Starfall would have been the end of him. So a nice attempt there, but just pulling himself out of the lane for a little bit longer. So Angel missing out on a little bit of farm. But his farm's already pretty decent anyway. Rushing up that Ring of a Cooler. So we see the Wraith Band already in there, so the Courier will fly that up a little bit later. So Phase Boost into a Cooler, so he really hits hard early on. Means Art Style, I mean, nah, the Darkseer. Everyone's Art Style and Dara. What? Yeah, just the Darkseer. He just can't play it. And again, the rune. Wolves are really making a big thing about this. Once they knew that Brewmaster was rushing the bottle, just after that point, everything just went into control that rune. Pull him off the lanes. Even Mergel came in for that one. And now he's probably not going to be in the best position ever. I mean, there's a lot of conversions here. In fact, we might even see a black hole. No, the conversions disappear. But he's still going to pop the black hole with nothing around. Support coming in, though. Bag is here. Shackle will go. Fissure will fly out from Mania in a couple of moments. He's looking for the angle, but he does not get it. And Miguel are trying to retreat back out again. He's running up towards the die now, running back out again. The stun, great timing there from Funic. Was waiting for the wind run to go so Mag can keep that stack up. Napalming stacking. Is there another stun? No, there is not. Not for another 6 seconds. And they will not dive this, or will Mag? Yeah, he wants to. They're going to dive back past the tower. Mag is tanking it up. So they switch themselves around. 4 levels up on the napalm. Now following through with the stun. We're seeing Shadow Demon dying in the meantime, but I want to watch that bottom lane double kill by Mag. And Lich is on the run back out too, so Shadow Demon, oh, looks like he was dying up there. Who managed to bring him down? Was it Art Style? Yeah, it was Lich. And looks like he used the ultimate too. So Frost and Lich ulti. Oh, you are kidding me. You are freaking kidding me. Do not do this to me now. Can't mouse it now. Do not fear, guys. Do not fear. Where there is a will, there is a technical solution. And... Yay! Mouse working again. Fantastic. Structures are fortified. Fantastic. Looks like we've got a bit of a accumulation of heroes on the bottom lane by Wolves. Might be looking at that tier 1 tower on bot. It's either that or they just want to kill somebody. But Funic just holding back at the tower. They got a ward just a little bit further up, so the vision for that ward, it kind of cuts out a little bit. I love how it's smack pain between two sentries. I just need someone across the river before they'll see it. Here's our bottom lane initiation. Enigma wants to go, getting shackled up there. Ryze just cursing and shackling a little bit. I think Miguel was looking for a little bit more of a power shot through that with level 4. And just a quick pause down from Art Style again, so not having the best time in the world. Just more delay. Here's God coming down. Is he looking for D-Wars, or is it's just the ping saying, yes, he's rotating. I might be looking towards Playmate in the middle lane. Just while we got this break, let's check out our gold graph as well as experience. That first little dip was when Batrider did this camp here. That was that first little dip. That would have been money and that experience dip. And then just a couple of kills going the way of Wolves and then back the other way of Dara. A lot of it just going with the momentum of the kills. There's no towers down just yet. The CS-wise, is anyone really going miles ahead of the others? We've got 61 on Miguel, so he's actually the most farmed here on the map. Angel not too far behind him on 46 for 17 denies. But up on that top lane, his counterpart, the Darkseer, already up at 48 for 2. Difficult to stop him from farming, and Angel kind of wanted that kill before. See, he even wants even more farm. Just that Ring of a Cooler, just set to inactive. So no extra armor. Normally get that plus 2 armor from the aura, but you can turn it on and off, just like you can the Radiance. So people kind of enjoy that. We just have to wait for art style to get out of that. I kind of want to just like hover here. I don't know if you can hear that in the background. Just the slow, rivery water. What does art style do when he rages? Is it just like, man, lag? Or is it just like, just listen to the waters of Dota? Outside of my body is a wonderful world where I get to play as an imaginary character with three normal abilities and one ultimate. There, it's serenity. The wonderful world of Dota 2. We all love to escape to. So we're just going to wait for Dara to come back into the game, and then we're going to be ready to rock and rumble. I say get ready to come back in the game. This is art style looking for the delay to end. Nice little friendly nudge. That's what it's all about. Let's remind too, after this game, Dara will keep on playing. Oh, Mag DC. Ah, okay, so Mag lost his connection. That's the reason. Yeah, he's DC'd out, so we'll wait for him to return back in again. Yeah, but the next game coming up after this one will be the ProDOTA match again. I've got two matches for you this evening, so it's Dara versus Wolves to kick us off. And secondary game is going to be along the lines of CLG, so Counter-Logic Gaming, the team who, if you missed it, was invited yesterday to the International, so they'll have a chance to play out for the $1 million first place. Actually, when did that news go out? I think it wasn't too far away. Yeah, it was, in fact, 22 hours ago. 22 hours ago, CLG was announced as the eighth contender, I think it is now, for the International. Always one way to check it out. Loading up the site, man. Yeah, so AL, Na'Vi, DK, Orange, eHome, IG, Complexity Gaming, as well as CLG have been announced. So there's only six more slots left. Only six more slots left, and then the wild cards to come from the two regional qualifiers, one for East, one for West. So that has been announced as well. So we've got two qualifiers to play through. If you have a hard time selecting the teams, hey, why not run a qualifier? It's a good way of doing it. But that is the International, which is not far away now. It's kind of crazy to think how far away it is. It's 3 months. 3 months with the International, 3 weeks, and we're over a DreamHack. If you are gonna, if you are from Sweden, I want to say hello. Obviously, it can't. My mic can't handle Sweden. Yeah, but if you are from over in Sweden, I want to say a big hello to you and come and say hi. I'll be there for the DreamHack tournament, the Corsair tournament over there. So come and say hi. We'll be doing the final in the Dream Arena, so everyone can come and join that one or watch the live stream over from the DreamHack website. We'll also have it available over at joinDOTA. So if you want to keep up to date with everything there, we will make sure it is it'll be exactly how the way you found the stream today. With the normal countdown, coming up to the matches, everything you possibly need. That's what we try and create at joinDOTA. Trying bit by bit, little by little. God, just getting cold snapped up a little bit there. Also doing the wires thing, landing off that stomp. It wasn't to kill off anybody, it was just to get rid of that creep wave. So if Invoker did die back past that tower, he would be taking up the damage. Nice little lucky power shot going through Funnick. Was just standing off to the side in the wrong position for himself. Angel setting up a top. He wants the kill, but he needs the angle on Darkseer. Darkseer just needs to stand back a little bit, but Darkseer being a melee, he's always going to be close in by with the rest of the creep wave. Oh, hello. Matt Ryder in mid. He doesn't have Blink Dagger up just yet. Three heroes pushing out the bottom lane after he leaves. Looking again for that 12-minute rune. And Playmate looking to deny again. If they're going to try and stop the 12-minute rune, nice shackle from Miguel. Funny, could be in a little bit of trouble. In fact, Windrunning in front of him. Looking to deal off enough damage to then get that last power shot off. It will be enough damage if he manages to latch it, and the power shot will fly. Fissure as well. It is not enough. Funny able to live through that one. In the meantime, Lich dies on the top rune. Looks like Angel rotated down for that one. And hello, God. He's going to spot three of them out there. Wants to go on Rise. Disruption to start with. That's just being a nuisance to God. It's not really to initiate. It's just so they can run back down towards that bottom lane and focus back on the tier 1 tower again. How's Angel looking in the meantime? Wants to get to that ultimate orb as soon as he can. Doesn't really want to probably get the Yasha straight up. Let's have those extra stat points. like he's everywhere on the map. His illusions are helping push out the middle lane while he's on top. Might have to leap and TP at this point, which he does do so, and leaps. Hang on! Whoa, 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 that's not a good place to leap to. Oh, really? They had no vision there? Oh, of course they didn't. No, there was the Radiant Creep Wave, not the Dire Creep Wave. So when he went whoop into here, the Creep Wave of his own could see in that direction. But because Dera were basically cut out of this line, they were over this direction. They couldn't see it at all. They're going to try and push out the tier 1 tower on the top lane, which they can do so. There's actually much which Wolves can do about this unless they bring a little bit more support in. Oh, hello. Maybe there is something. Angel just manages to land the arrow. Now support's going to come in. Enigma sees 2, sees 3. They get the last hit in the tower, destroyed by Enigma. And Dark's here, disrupted. Ilsebi is dead. Nothing can really stop it. Power Shot was already lining up by Miguel. But Enigma gets back out and they only lose the Dark's here. And now they're looking at Playmate. Miranda Ultimate's going to make it harder to look at Playmate because he's going invisible. Still, that's a decent trade-off for both teams on the top. They kill off a Darkseer who, if he does, if he gets that pipe up early on... Actually, what's he already got? He's already got the hood. Headdress isn't really that expensive, so he probably didn't lose that much. Oh, that was the longest EMP of my life. What was that? The charge time. No wonder, 3.15, now it's 2.8. That's a little bit better. Try and get that down a little bit lower if possible. Starstyle's able to get picked off on the bottom lane. It's like it was a leap to a Starfall. Or a Starfall to a leap so we can chase, and now the T1's had to go down the mid lane. So Wolves, they able to make Dera hurt a little bit. They've managed to bring down two of the T1 towers for the price of one on the top lane, and it cost Dera a Darkseer to do so. So that gold is not 100% the way of Dera, and that's going to update in a couple of moments' time. In fact, it should be up towards zero in a couple of moments, but just sitting above the 500 for Dera, which is nothing for 15 minutes into a game. That's absolutely nothing. Bit of counter warding. Ryze even just using that Shadow Poison for a little bit of vision up on the high ground. It gives you enough.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
Angel in the meantime, yeah, there's that. Cash getting bigger and bigger. But I think they really even know, and this is the biggest problem I see when people just... It was kind of like what a Vorst used to do as the Mirana. As that ultimate orb. Just farms. You don't really feel it, because Mirana is one of those heroes which think, yeah, she's great in mid-game. Fantastic in mid-game, but oh, wait, she's not engaging us, so wait, we shouldn't worry. Mid lane push, hello. Spin up in the air by Playmate, tries to catch him out, but they're already too far down. Brewmaster with that Blink Dagger just pops off Ryze. Now I'm hearing, yep, there's Mania being pulled down as the Earthshaker. Nemo will take a fall. Angel's on the run after Arstyle, who will TP himself out to safety unless Angel can find him, which he does, but he can't kill him in time. And Batrider's trying to Firefly out to safety. Now he will TP as well, just in the right position between two of the Western Wolves guys. In fact, four of them. Just one coming from the high and three from the low. And only losing the Enigma round for that one. And they didn't lose a tier 1 tower either, but Dera just pushing the limits a little bit. So it is a 1-1 hero trade because it was a Ryze for an Enigma. Don't think that they didn't pick off the Earthshaker. He just managed to get Lasso pulled out of the fight so he, he couldn't be in a position to help control it. Now the push to the tier 1 tower on top. Power shots to fly, Creep Wave to destroy. New one to come in and tank it up for him. And then three into Wex. So he wants to bring down the towers hard and fast. That's what it's all about. And you'll see that later on, well, she's got EMP as well as Tornado. I'm waiting for Alacrity to come out from Invoker. If he wants to start to level that up. Just so he can give that to the Mirana. And you will love the extra damage as opposed to the damage which he's currently taking. Iron Shell to go. Vacuum a little bit closer, but always with that leap, the escape mechanism's there. Enigma. I don't think that was intentional. Ryze disrupted him, and now he's going to turn around with a black hole. Instantly stunned. He thought he could take it, and now the Mirana Oldman tries to pull him back out. Is there dust? There's a stomp. Yeah, there's dust. So they got the reveal off. Mania will be shackled up. Curry's even going to fly out supplies for this one. Shadow Demon to go. Mania to pop as well. And the TP's out from the rest of Wolves. Good time to carry that dust. Really good time to carry that dust. Who was it? It was the Batrider who had the dust. So able to make Wolves pay a little bit for that. They go back to their farming, and that's Darkseer. Yeah, that's Pipe, or... Oh, is it? No, I think he's 200 short. Try to do my math in my head while trying to control the camera. That's a great idea. So let's look at stats while someone's going to die. Actually, that always happens, so this is one way to get kills. We can look around and just check out... Yeah, see, look, instantly just pinging R-style in the middle lane. Angel wants this. But there's a pause back. That's about right. Mag just going to pause it. Don't know if that was an intentional or just a finger slip. And Darkseer resumes, and Mag is like, no, man, I want to stop this at the same time that Angel hurls that arrow. And you can see it coming, so R-style will know what's coming at him. Just that line. Straight towards R-style. How fast can you move? Actually, not. He does have boots. That should be fast enough. All he's got to do is just like spam his button to the right and he'll be fine. Yeah, but in the meantime, I was going to use this to try and bait out a kill, and it might be happening in the middle lane. But we can check out our CS as well as gold. So gold is over 700 at this point, and as far as our experience goes, I would love to show you, but it's currently hidden there. But you can see down the bottom corner, just down. Actually, can you guys see that? Actually, I don't think my mouse is being captured. LOL! Yeah, but 25-200 to the 25-380. So only 180 difference. Very, very minimal. Very, very minimal. It's just a CS the individual players got to look at. And as always, Angel, it's one big thing which the Wolves are really, really good at doing. It's just getting Angel that farm. So 3-0-1, 92 for 21. Okay, go call is now going to come. So let's watch Art Style. And he should dodge this pretty easily. He knows it's coming in. He can see it very, very clearly. So just the walk off to the side, and he got hit by it. Leap and Starfall will get this kill, but they don't want it. He was tanking up the creep wave a hell of a lot, and now he's going to get an urn charge from Mag. I thought he's going to dodge that. It's possible also he was taken off the footing because he was casting something, the frost, at the time. So might have needed to wait for the end of that animation before he'd be free to move around. First power shot at long, long range to fly through, and you'll have a second one in 2 seconds. But the fissure also blocking off the creep wave. And the illusions just hold it off. And even though the entire Dara side is here, they got no black hole. They do, however, have mech, and yeah, there's a pipe just flowing in. So if they want to push, they can do so. One blink dagger. Oh, that is just ridiculous damage. R-Style was low to start with, and now he's gone. They would have wanted his ultimate for this one, but just the fissure as well as power shot. Shackle trying to latch up, almost had the line for Enigma. Blink on down from Brewmaster, didn't start off with a stomp. Fissure popping off there from Mania, as always, it's such a great ES. Midnight Pulse trying to clear off the trees, they got some room to move here. Playmate being pulled back out again. He's disrupted as well as being caught in the Firefly. Dust to pop off, so Noah can go invis. Echo Slam popping off from Mania. Two already down for Dara. Really? Did he get out of that one? Stun going off an Angel. There's just to hold him out of the fight. There goes Batrider popping off. God's on the run from Miguel. And he might be able to catch this one up. He's just going to want the angle for the shackle. There's one tree to really latch him to. So mini stun for the moment. No four staffs to go. Arrow will fly out there, but God runs high. And Wolves will focus towards the middle there. Dara really at that point, they committed so much to go for that T1 tower in the middle lane. And it would have worked for them if, one, they didn't lose Lich, and two, they didn't get their entire team caught in half. Mania's fissure straight down the middle just changed that fight completely. And because of it, that means Wolves can push in harder. And they're looking towards that middle. Ryze just disrupting up the Enigma. Earthshaker cops a little bit of damage. That's his death. The Shulman will bounce back to him. It's actually the Frost from Lich which gets the last hit. So the Earthshaker's down. They'll go again. Lichology is down, but Enigma's comes up. So if they need to fight this, they probably can. A T1 tower has been brought down the middle lane, but it was denied by the Earthshaker before. So at least that's something for Dara. As you can see, Wolves are just coming out on top of a lot of these engagements. Sitting at 10 for 9, the experience going up as well. I'm here in bottom lane, it's going to be Brewmaster going to his doom. Spin goes up, very, very fast blink there by Gob. I don't think he meant that one. Caught inside the trees, the arrow manages to hit in that one as well. He saw the path of where he had to be. And trying to pop off anything which he had was just not going to work. Invoker gets the last right click in. So a kill for Playmate. Again, having success on that Invoker. I think it was TPL or it was Star Series, which I saw Playmate playing as his Invoker. Getting to the point where just no one can touch him. And it's hard enough to touch him as it is. Like, that guy's walking around with drums and a four staff and phase boots. The movement speed on Playmate when he pops that off is max. Or close to. Seeing Darkseer trying to hold up this middle lane. Mitchie can easily do. He's got more than enough regeneration coming from that pipe. Would like some, probably some real treads. Arrow's already flowing out there. Art style. Careful, man. That Mirana really hurts. And now the Cold Snap Starfall. Art style's dead. Didn't even pop off a single ability. And now, oh, Mania. The Fissure Trap, is it there? No, they want to still fight this one off. It's Playmate putting off the EMP. It was Gold being sent up in the air as well. Now Mania, lassoed in place, gets the Echo off, gets the stomp, will knock it out of here safely. Brewmaster with the last right click. But Nias for a Lich, and now, hello. Are we going to try and find an arrow for Wolves and try and make something on this bottom lane? If possible, Power Shot to damage down a little bit. With four heroes from Dera, it's not going to be the easiest thing to stand against. And Dera control their lane, so if they want to push out this bottom lane and take out the tier 1, they can do so. Wolves had to try and spam defend. And that's the reason why we're seeing Miguel using up a lot of mana before the fight even starts with the power shots. He just wants that creep wave gone. Arrow will fly out, holding the Darkseer back, but Brewmaster is their main force. He wants to go in. Already popping off that Lincoln Spear? Really? That's up on Angel to start with, so he didn't end up going for the Mana Style, but who cares about that one? Black Hole's got to set up right now with a Flame Break. It pushes him out! The Shackle then came out from Windrunner. Holding the Enigma out. Man, you can just warm for that kind of stuff. Lich Ultimate bouncing itself around, wants to go back up to Playmate, but it's not going to. Gets one here out for that one, then another great arrow. Brewmaster has picked up the double kill. So it has still gone the way of Dare in the end, but that could have been a catastrophe there by Mag. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. But the Wolves being three down, maybe the push will keep going. It's a tier two tower they can bring to ruin. 17 seconds for the Windrunner. Oh, she might be up by the time they get back there. It's not going to stop them from doing a little bit of damage to it. While the rotation comes in towards the middle lane, Angel's caught out, leaves himself away. And Gol wants to chase, but he's already used the Blink Dagger to get there. So Angel gets to go back to his farming game. That Lincoln's Fear, I really don't know about this one. It's not the way Angel has been building his Mirana. The old one orb starts it. And does give you the option. You can switch between the Mantra or you can go into the Lincoln's, but... Now Lincoln's Fear, when you've got so many abilities that can just pop it off, and it was the Drunken Haze. It was the Drunken Haze of Brewmaster, which he threw out. Which triggered the Lincoln's to start with. And then he was just forced back. He couldn't be that damage dealer. He's not an intimidation to Dera. It's a build that lets him live. Sure, that's great. Not a single death to his name. 133 CS. Fantastic. But if it loses the team fights for the rest of your squad, and now for the first time in the game, Dera have the advantage as far as kills go. Well, second time. And that's going to start to be a bit of a problem. Dera's experience. Yep, we're back to zero. Gold. Also diving down. A decent chunk after that last fight, also because they took out that tier 1 tower on bottom lane. But just brings it back slowly the way of Dera. And brings up these items, which they also need. Hello, is that a smoke gank coming through? They're going to find out. Yep, there's Darkseer. Fissured, Stun, Curse, Enigma. No black holes. Get yourself out there, man. Spin up in the air. Actually catching both and invoking against Lassia and Darkseer because of the fall. And four staff down from Miguel. Is he looking for a shackle? The line's not right. And Flame Break from Mag. Just in case the Wolves were thinking about chasing down further, but all they wanted was the one kill. Now they can take the tier 2 on top. So it was gank and push, gank and push, gank and push. So setting up. Dire's top tower is under attack. Is Dera going to defend this one? The black hole's still on cooldown, so they won't want to. The Mag has blinked to lasso. So they'll hold him off for now, and they'll look for a little bit of a little bit of an opening. The fact we've got an Invis Panda out in the field, and that could find the opening. Oh, was there a Sentry Ward watching that? I might have seen him pop off the Invis when he first did it. That's a long run back there from Wolves. And the Power Shot to go as well. So God finds him. One's TP'd out, and basically Miguel... Oh, he bumped then. He's looking for the block, and this is right from God. He's waiting for the rest of his teammates to come in. He's only got maybe 3-4 seconds left on that invis rune, and there's a runaway. So Drunken Haze, blink on down, stomp as well, 4 staff out, and nice little fishing there from Mania. Shackle won't lash, but Brewmaster is still held up long enough. Arrow's gonna fly in, knocking on anybody. In fact, the Flame Break just pushing Angel back out of that invis. And they will retreat back Dara into their own jungle. Oh, if they take out the farm from the creep wave on top. In fact, they might even push that tier 2 on top. They've got enough heroes to do so. Black Hole is up. Arstar's got his ulti too. Mag's got that ulti up. So is Brewmaster. Yeah, go for it, guys. This is the time to push. However, they are being counter-pushed by Playmate in the bottom lane. But Playmate also doesn't have a TP scroll. And they might see this. That means Playmate's going to walk all the way back to Secret Shop if he wants to try and stop this one. While Mag is initiating, blinking himself in, lassoing and picking off the Earthshaker. And now they'll bring down the tier 2. All they can look for is the trade. And that's going to be the tier 2 on bot, which Playmate will be able to take off because it's so low on life. While Dara bring down a tower from full life on the top lane. Or maybe even be able to get back in time. No, they're not going to. Angel, look for that arrow. Look for that arrow to fly. Maybe not, because he's already popped it. It's like, look for that arrow to fly. No, wait, it's on cooldown because he already used it. Irish snap. Agon himself is now done for the Brewmaster. Decreased cooldown, increased duration, and increases power of the warriors. AKA makes Brewmaster a pain in the living ass. As opposed to the dead ass. Enigma 2. BKB is done for him now. Mech as well. So nothing's gonna stop that ultimate of his. There's only a couple of things that can do it. Actually, there's 4 on the Western Wall side. Not including everything else which he gets from his stun. I'm talking mainly Fissure, Arrow from Mirana, Shadow Demon Imprisonment, as well as a Windrunner Shackle. And we have the Invoker Call Snap. Darkseer just tanking it for a team. It's like, I got this! For the greater good! Iron Shell's already up. They're preparing for the fight. They want to kill off Roshan, but they all don't want to be inside the pit. If they know the second they do, Wolves can try and find advantage. Spin will go up, picks up one, EMP. Might make life a little bit more difficult for Funnik, but he's got himself a Sol Ring, already popping off the Mech. Arstar caught out, really split off from the rest of his team even more because of that Fissure from Mania. Blink up from Mag, pops off the dust, he's searching for Angel. Not going to find him, got to go in towards the middle lane now. Is there a surge, is there something, there's a blink in, a stomp. Again going for that Earthshaker, wanting to stop him up before the Fissure gets to pop again. Small stuns, holding Playmate in, and nice Black Call from Funnik. 3 of them being brought back in. Everything is there. The wall, the Iron Shell, and all the blood of the Western Wolf side. Bar Miguel is on the run away. Napalm level 2 stack now. Windrunner's worn off. They run inside. There's the Midnight Pulse. Just clearing off the trees. They got all the vision in the world. And now they will go for Roshan. 4 of them going on down. That team fight potential of Dara. It could be so upset by that Earthshaker, and it was too. We saw the Lich go down for that one. Arstar wasn't even involved in this fight. And then the Earthshaker. We're going again? Really? Arrow to fly in from Angels. Making Dara think twice about this, but they can still finish it. Well, they should be able to. They are Black Hole down, Wall down, everything else down. Every ultimate was popped by Liches. They got Roshan very, very easy. The 30-minute mark, and we're going to see their first Roshan. They go to God, make him even more powerful. No, they're going to give it to the Enigma. Surprisingly as well, the Enigma. Sure, you get the mech back again, and you get a couple more stuns. But once that Black Hole has popped, that Black Hole has popped. It does become a bit of a bait. You can try and focus down Funnik before he gets a Black Hole. He could walk in a position where it's like, you know what, this Black Hole is really going to hit hard. Or we can go the other way around. And that's Black Hole to pop. Not a problem at all. I'm going to hold on to it. Aegis will go. Now the Black Hole goes. Or do I pop the Black Hole early? I'm going to watch Funnik so damn closely during the next match. During the next team fight, that is. Next match probably as well. Dara, of course, they're going to be back here in a couple of moments' time after they finish this one. Got a game up against CLG, Counter Logic Gaming. How are we looking now? We're trying to build towards... Okay, we're going to go MKB. So it's... It's funnily enough, the normal second top tier item for Angel But normally, as a mana style, is his first one, so he becomes a huge amount of damage. That Lingens, it just doesn't work for him. How are we looking for all the support items? We've got mechs up on either side. Mikel's got one, we've got Enigma with the other. We've got Arcane Boots, just a couple of them. None actually for Dara. Dara not going with any Arcane Boots at all. Oh no, there's one. What are we talking about? Darkseer having one. And considering there's an EMP flying out there from Invoker, you would have thought they might have stacked up a little bit more, but then again, that EMP hasn't really been that hugely effective from Playmate. I think he managed to get one where he drained off majority of the mana of Enigma. Just one of these things where Dara just keeps splitting themselves up. When they want to go teamfight, they do. That's called a blink in from Mag as their initiation. It's a blink in from God. So they can keep their entire team split up. So things like that EMP tornado, and it will only happen when you get yourself into choke points. Which it kind of did a little bit around here. But they still managed to split themselves out. So as well as Iron Shell up on Mag, so just in case anyone was coming a little bit close towards that creep wave. We got an invis up on Art Style, so the Sacrificial Lamb is up again. At least he's level 11 now. They're set up for middle lane. While the bottom lane's been pushed out by Angel and top lane's been pushed by Miguel. So the split push is there, so Dara will take the tier 2 and mid. This will not be opposed. But in the meantime, Angel keeps pushing out the bottom lane. Miguel destroys the top tier 2. And Fortification will slow them down a little bit, and Angel won't stop. I don't think Miguel will either. Dara have been stalled up too much, and they're going to have to TP back if they want to defend this one. Either that, or they try and take the bait. And say the damage to our tier 3s, not a problem, we can do more. And they're going to as well. There's the blink in already from God. He's searching out for anybody around here. So the bottom lane pushes there. Top lane has fallen back. And the rest of Dara will fall back too. So Dara were the ones looking to go chicken, playing chicken with him. And Batrider returns towards the bottom lane. That was just a, do you want to have a base race? Pretty sure with our team all assembled in that middle lane, we can probably race it faster, was the call going out from Dara. But Wolves also did the right thing. Tier 2 for a tier 2. That's what it ended up becoming. And a little bit of farm for the side lane, as well as map control. And now Wolves, where do you go from here? They need a tier 2 tower to go down the middle, but they know they can't fight Dara head on. Not with all their ultimates up. So the only thing they can really try and do is catch out those farmers. And there's only really, well, even then they're babysitting each other. Mag and Darkseer right next to each other. Arstyle being the cautious one in the middle lane. And he's already trying to get enough life points as he is. Point booster, bracer, bracer. And just keeps up with the consumables. He's got everything he's probably going to buy apart from consumables now. Monkey King bar is finished for Mirana. So even more damage and also faster damage down towards this tier 3 tower. Meaning you can attack from the low ground and get the true hit up. Which I don't think that works entirely on towers. I'm trying to remember my game mechanics. Yeah, True Strike prevents your attacks from missing. I'm not quite sure if it has this effect on towers. I know Durka is currently tuning in. He might be able to spam me up the answer to that one. Hello, Dara. Running around the bottom and they find the courier. Has been killed. Like to know what was on that little guy. Now the initiation to go. BKB with the black hole going in. Holding Angel's Wall's Playman out. Lich Ultimate perfect there from Arstyle. Ryan to the hero. Starseer Wall pulls Ryan's back in as well. And Mania will take the fall. Finally enough, he's going down as a third hero. That's a bit of a change. But Playmate's on the run. The blink up from Enigma. They know he must have run high. And yeah, there he is. The frost from Arstyle with the last right click will get the kill for him. Four heroes gone for Wolves. And Dara will either make a beeline for the middle lane, or they'll make a beeline for that tier 2 on the bottom. Something tells me they're going to be looking at mid. That's a faster possible Rax for them. It's exactly what they want. They've still got the Aegis up on Funnic. Fine enough, that's going to be reclaimed soon. Over there we go. Dara assembling in the middle lane. 30 second opening. Have we got buyback? No, we do not. Oh, yeah, we do on Invoker, though. Buyback is ready, so we might have to use it. Either that, they lose their mid. They need that EMP tornado, but 20 seconds. And it's a high cost as well as 1k gold. So ES trying to hold him off with just one starting fissure. Blink on down, looking for someone. Nice shackle there from Miguel. A lot of damage being dealt to Mag, or missing on the power shot, however. Shackle was perfect. Power shot a little bit astray. Shadow Poison continuing to try and bring down this wave, and they might have bought themselves enough time. The tier 3 tower will still take a fall. Shackle will manage to land, so God. Darrow might be forced to fight this one. Arrow flying out, but doesn't get us hit. So Darrow fall back. Happy to remove that tier 3, which means now they have a faster opening down the middle lane. But they want a team fight. They want to find someone. The problem is they've only got one ulti up, and it's coming from this guy here, Mag. So they want one person to roam out. And Playmate, it's going to be him. Mag is seeing a little bit further back there. There's not all the best vision in the world. Now he's going to see him. So Dara, Firefly's already up. Blink, Stomp, Stun, Lasso, holding Playmate in place. They will bring him down. An instant buyback. So the money is finally spent. He waited before, but the money is spent this time around. And Darrow's going to be happy with that one. They found themselves a pickoff. In the meantime, though, Angel continues to push out that bottom lane. And while he does so, there's more and more farm going his way.
Feeling no pain.
We got flying out for the courier. We got BKB. Courier should be back up again in 6 seconds. I want to see what was on this courier. Something was flying out. 2 seconds and 1 second, and courier will now respawn. Smoke. Okay, I was thinking it might be something critical. It's just smoke. All right. Dara in towards the middle lane. They're going to go again. Oldies are all up for them, apart from the Batrider one, which they used just before. Power shots flying through, and this is a better EMP. A lot of heroes from Dara just losing off the mana. Mania, however, way too far, and he's trying to get that Echo Slam off. Great vacuum and wall again. Now Playmate lassoed. He is brought back. Nice little low cooldown on that little sucker. Miguel being disrupted out there, but he'll still come back up again. Maybe he won't. No, the Black Hole ends. And Miguel runs out through the bottom. He'll be stunned and being chased on down. The mid ranks, however, is all smoke and mirrors. Darkseer TP's towards the bottom lane. Mirana is the one down here. Managed to already get himself a double kill. Wow, Angel, are you doing this by yourself? Double kill for him. He's going to take the melee racks on the bottom. Fortification trying to slow him down. The mid racks is gone for Wolves. God's even going to take a fall, diving back past the tower. Shackle will latch and hold him in place just long enough for the power shot to fly through, bringing him down. So now, Wolves had themselves with a, well, it's not a full racks advantage. It's only the melee, but that's still enough. Momentum towards the bottom and a tier 2 town for Dara to go through. Ballsy play from Angel. And he continues to get more and more farm. 5.2k. That's his mantra if he wants it. If he wants to go down those lines. And he, well, with Malphus out there and any other effect which you might get on top of him, it's not a bad thing to do. And look at Enigma getting so big. Reaver is now up on Funnic. Mirana has got to spend that money. The damage, the power which comes out of this Mirana is just ridiculous. He's going to buy a TP scroll now, so he has that. Yep, there we go. 6,100. What do you need, Angel? 814, 292. It's definitely not farm, it's definitely not kills. 180 is the closest for is on Funnic. But he's not the damage dealer. He's the man just buying up items so he can just stand there and just keep stunning. He's still walking around with an Aegis. Which is now just exactly reclaimed at that point I'm looking at him. So now Roshan comes up alive. And Dara might go it again. Top lane push from Angel.
Invisibility.
This makes Dara think twice about it. God will come up to defend and he's got himself his own Reaver. So now the whole thing is maybe if I get enough life points we can just tank through the entire battle. Use our epicness to deal with whatever damage which is still out from Mirana. Hello, he's spent his money. What is it? A full manta? Butterfly. So we've got evasion up for him.